Good morning. I'm Jae-young Jung from Seoul National University in Korea. I'm going to present our new system-level approach for improving lifetime of NAND flash-based storage systems using a cross-layer optimization technique between system software and NAND device. This study was done in collaboration with my colleagues Sang-Shin Han, Song Jin-Yi, and my advisor, Professor Jiyoung Kim. I will start by introducing the lifetime issue in NAND flash-based storages. This figure shows the growing trend of NAND device technologies from two representative device components. Until now, the NAND capacity doubles every 2 years by advanced device technologies. As a result, NAND flash-based storages are widely adopted from mobile to enterprise systems. Most of system researchers are not familiar with low-level device behaviors, so I will describe the key idea of our cross-layer approach using a simple cartoon called Flashman, which represents our flash-chip FTL layer. NAND flash memory is like sheets of paper. Then, a program operation in a NAND device can be thought as writing with a pencil. And an eraser operation as erasing with an eraser. Let me introduce Flashman, who writes letter and erases paper. Flashman is ready to write letter on paper. He writes some letters, and the fast is ongoing, he scrolls all over the paper. Eventually, free space is exhausted. So, for writing summary of this talk, he should erase the paper with an eraser. Flashman works hard and paper is successfully erased. These are basic NAND operations. However, the NAND endurance was drastically decreased last 5 years as a side effect of recent advanced technologies. Then what is the NAND endurance and why is endurance decreased? Let's go back to Flashman. It seems that our Flashman works out hard. He writes letter, and for erasing paper, he grabs an eraser very powerfully. Then erases paper. He repeats writing and erasing paper very diligently. After 3,000 repetitions of writing and erasing, paper is eventually worn out. Therefore, the NAND endurance can be thought as the maximum number of write and erase cycles until a NAND cell is worn out. Our freshman changes paper from thick one to thin one. Then what happens? Also, he writes letter, and he grabs an eraser. I think strong freshman does not seem to use thin paper for a long time. He also repeats writing and erasing paper very hard. Unfortunately, only after 2,000 repetitions, paper is worn out. This is because thin paper wears down more easily than thick one. At this time, I believe that everyone briefly understand low-level NAND characteristics. Then let's go back to the trend of NAND technologies. The total amount of writes means how much write the storage can handle throughout its lifespan. For a NAND flash-based storage, it is proportional to capacity and endurance. However, the total amount of writes does not increase as much as we expected because of decreasing NAND endurance. The lifetime of storage system is defined as the total amount of writes divided by the daily amount of data. Because of decreasing total amount of writes, the lifetime of NAND flash-based storage also did not increase as much as we expected. However, if daily amount of data is increased by a recent data explosion, the lifetime will be further degraded. Therefore, decreasing NAND endurance is regarded as a main barrier for sustainable growth in the NAND flash-based storage market. Until now, many lifetime enhancing techniques have been mainly focused on reducing write amplification factor. For example, garbage collection and wear labeling techniques have been improved to increase the efficiency of FTL algorithms. Moreover, to reduce daily amount of data, for reduce daily workload, various system-level approaches such as deduplication, compression, and throttling techniques have been proposed. On the other hand, pure system-level techniques were proposed for improving the NAND endurance. Because of the layered software architecture, devices and system have been independently developed. Therefore, we propose a cross-A optimization technique for improving the NAND endurance. I present a key idea to improve the NAND endurance also by using Freshman. Freshman learns a good lesson. He lays back and relaxes his arm. Also, he writes letter and he holds a soft eraser instead of a hard eraser. Then he also repeats writing and erasing with a soft eraser very slowly. Fortunately, Freshman can write and erase 4,000 times. To use NAND flash memory for a long time, we would better to slowly erase NAND cells with a lower erase voltage as long as possible. This figure is a cross-section view of NAND flash memory cells. In a program operation, when a program voltage is applied to the control gate, electrons are injected into the memory cells. Then data are stored as the form of different threshold voltages. In an erase operation, when an erase voltage is applied to the memory cell, they are erased so that threshold voltages move down to erased state. In this erase operation, memory cells are mainly damaged by a high erase voltage. On the other hand, when memory cells are slowly erased with a lower erase voltage, memory cells are less damaged compared to the fast erase with a high erase voltage. Therefore, we can understand that erase voltage and time have a critical impact on the improving NAND endurance. Our proposed approach is motivated by the NAND device physics model on the endurance degradation. Erase voltage scaling exploits the trade-off relationship between endurance and erase voltage. And erase time scaling exploits the trade-off between endurance and erase time. Frame time scaling is necessary for writing data to NAND blocks erased with different erase voltages. By combining device-level scaling techniques, we propose a new system-level approach called Dynamic Programming Erase Scaling, or DPES. The DPES approach dynamically changes frame time and erase voltage time depending on workload condition for improving the NAND endurance without degradation in the overall write throughput. I present the key components of the DPS approach. This figure shows how much the NAND damage is reduced by lowering an erase voltage from NAND cycling test by changing the erase voltages. As illustrated by Freshman example, a soft eraser can improve the endurance of paper. Similarly, the NAND endurance can be improved by lowering an erase voltage. Since different erase voltages degrade the NAND endurance by different amount, we introduce a new reliability metric called effective wearing, which represents the effective degree of NAND wearing after one P cycle instead of the number of P cycles. As shown in this figure, erasing with a lower erase voltage can significantly reduce the effective wearing compared to deep erase. Also, slowly erasing can improve the NAND endurance, similar to Freshman example. Fast erasing affects the effective wearing by 1.0. This is default condition. On the other hand, slowly erasing affects only by 0.8. If increased erase time is acceptable, slow erase is another way of improving the NAND endurance. Erase voltage scaling and time scaling can be combined with each other. When a NAND block is erased, if we can slowly erase a NAND block with a reduced erase voltage, the NAND endurance can be increased. For example, when you use the default erase voltage and speed, defect wearing per 1P cycle is 1. After 3,000 P cycles, the total sum of effect wearing is also 3,000. On the other hand, if we use the minimum erase voltage and slow erase speed, the effect wearing can be reduced to 0.4. After 3,000 P cycles, the total sum of effect wearing is only 1,200. If P cycles are repeated until the total sum of the effect wearing reached 3,000, endurance can be increased more than twice over the default case. However, there exists side effect of the erase voltage scaling. Compared to erase an end block with a default erase voltage, when a lower erase voltage is used, that block is shallowly erased. So, threshold voltage window is reduced by the decrease in the erase voltage. Therefore, when a low erase voltage is used, threshold voltage distribution should be formed within the narrow threshold voltage window. Then, how to form a narrow threshold voltage distributions? NAND flash memory is programmed using the incremental stepless program scheme, where the program voltage is increased step by step. For example, we are programming two NAND blocks which are differently erased. For a deeply erased cell, the number of program loops is 3, and frame time is proportional to the number of loops. On the other hand, in order to program a shallowly erased cell, a fine-grained program control is needed to form a narrow threshold voltage distribution. As a result, the program time is increased. We can conclude that program control should be differently adjusted for blocks erased with different erase voltages. In this work, we use 5 different erase voltage modes, from EV mode 0 to 4. When an erase block is programmed again, there is a strict requirement on the minimum frame time, which depends on the used erase voltage. For example, if EV mode 4 if EV mode 4 is used when erasing, it is needed at least twice longer program time. On the other hand, if EV mode 0 is used, the erase block is programmed as fast as possible. We defined 5 different write modes from mode 0 to 4. Write mode 0 is the fastest write mode, while write mode 4 is the slowest write mode. When a high erase voltage and fast erase speed are used for erasing, we can achieve high performance while endurance is degraded. On the other hand, when a low erase voltage and slow erase speed are used, we can achieve endurance benefit, but performance will be degraded. Our DPS approach dynamically changes program and erase scaling. Both performance and endurance can be achieved. We modified a NAND device to support multiple erase voltage mode and write mode, and multiple erase speed mode. Our DPS approach enables the software module to exploit the trade-off relationship between the NAND endurance and the erase voltage and time. Based on the DPS approach, we have implemented a DPS-aware FTL called AuroFTL. I'm going to briefly explain the implementation concept of AuroFTL. Basic functions of an existing FTL are address mapping, garbage collection, and rear labeling. AuroFTL automatically changes erase and program voltage and times depending on write throughput requirements, while the overall throughput should not be affected. AuroFTL has some additional modules for DPS support. From NAND characterization result, we make the NAND endurance model. And mode selector decides the most suitable write and erase mode based on the buffer utilization. Mapping table is also extended for DPS support. In response to write and erase mode, NAND flash memory is set to the target configuration through a new device setting interface before normal operations. Next, I'm going to explain how the DPS manager decides the write and erase mode. When a write request incoming, the buffer utilization is updated. Based on the utilization, the mode selector chooses the most appropriate write mode and erase voltage mode, voltage and time mode. And then, NAND setting table informs NAND device how to configure its internal settings through new device setting interface. In selecting multiple modes, firstly, the write mode I is selected. If there is no flip-flop, erase voltage mode J and time mode K are chosen. And then, after valid pages in a victim block are moved, then that block is erased with mode J and K. When there are pre-blocks which are matched with the target write mode I, that block can be written with mode I. The DPS manager chooses the most appropriate write mode depending on the buffer utilization, which reflects the write stroke requirements. In order of FTL, the DPS manager uses a simple circular buffer for estimating the available frame time for a given workload. The circular buffer queues incoming write requests before they are written, and the mode selector adaptively changes the write mode. For example, when incoming requests are intensive so that buffer utilization is increased, the mode selector tries to use the fast write mode. On the other hand, when incoming rate becomes slow, buffer utilization is decreased, then slow write mode can be selected. Similar to write selection, write mode selection, erase voltage mode can be also selected based on the buffer utilization. For example, current buffer utilization is about 30%, and most suitable write mode is 3. When there is no free space in NAND flash storage before programming, garbage collection is invoked. During copying pages and erasing operations, NAND flash memory cannot serve incoming requests, so buffer utilization is effectively increased to 50%. So we use effective utilization which reflects page copy and erase times. In this example, since the effective wearing is increased to 50%, the DPS manager chooses write mode 2. For a foreground garbage collection, we can pre-estimate the next write mode, so erase voltage mode can be accurately selected. In selecting an erase speed mode, the DPS manager selects an erase mode which does not affect the write throughput. Similar to garbage collection case, decision is also based on the effective utilization. To estimate the effect of erase time, we convert the erase time to buffer utilization as shown in this equation. For example, there are 100 entries in the buffer and two buffer whose initial utilizations are different. Increasing the utilization by fast and slow erase mode can be estimated. Slow erase mode can be selected for buffer A, but for buffer B, we cannot select a slow erase mode because of the buffer overflow. When a fast write mode is selected, if there are only shallowly erased blocks, programming cannot be served because of mismatch between erase mode and write mode. For example, when a fast write mode is used for a shallowly erased cell, switch voltage distributions get out of the reliability limit. Then, a garbage collection is necessary to prepare a deeply erased block, but its cost is very high. Is there any efficient method to use fast write mode for a shallowly erased block? In this case, a shallowly erased block is additionally erased with a low erase voltage during a short time interval. We call this method the rage erase. After rage erase, that block can be programmed with a fast write mode. I will discuss experimental result and conclude my talk. To evaluate effectiveness of the proposed OrFTL, we used 6 enterprise traces. Buffer size was set to 32 megabytes, which is the typical size of HDD-based storage. 5 different write and erase voltage mode and 2 erase speed mode were used. Finally, NAND flash memories were configured to 8 channels, and each channel consists of 4 chips. In this configuration, ideally, 32 chips can serve incoming requests simultaneously. We used 6 different enterprise traces. To estimate the effect of our DPS approach, we analyzed distributions of interlock times for traces. For each comparison, traces were normalized over effective program time in the multiple channel environment. Among 6 traces, Project Zero trace was relatively fast, while there were lots of slow requests in WebZero trace. Since the TPS approach exploits the idle times between requests, we can expect that endurance gain for WebZero trace will be larger than for fast trace, such as Project Zero and Source2 traces. We evaluated the endurance gain for two different techniques, baseline and AutoFTL. Baseline is an existing TPS unaware FTL, which always use the fastest write mode and deep erase mode. AutoFTL is the proposed TPS aware FTL that dynamically changes multiple erase and write mode. To measure the endurance gain, each trace was repeated until the total sum of effect wearing reached 3,000. Endurance gain for AutoFTL were normalized over that of baseline. The black bars are with baseline and the blue ones are with AutoFTL. As shown in this graph, AutoFTL improves endurance by 69% on average over baseline. Overall, the improvement on endurance is proportional to interval allowed times as we expected. This is because the longer interval allowed times are, the more likely slow write and erase mode are selected. For example, endurance gain for Proxy Zero and Proxy Zero is larger than that for Source 2. This is because for Proxy Trace, more than 80% of requests were written with the slowest mode, while for Source 2 Trace, only about 40% of requests were written with the slowest mode. As shown in this figure, even though AutoFTL use slow erase and write mode frequently, the decrease in the overall write throughput over baseline was less than 2.2% as we expected. This is because AutoFTL accurately changes the erase and write mode by exploiting idle times. And in our evaluations for enterprise traces, lazy erases were very rare, less than one lazy erase per 1,000 erases. These two figures show that the effect of the erase time scaling mode on the endurance gain and overall write throughput. As shown in the first figure, the slow erase mode can improve the NAND endurance up to 18%, and it slightly degrade the overall write throughput up to 2.1%. So you can conclude that erase time scaling is another useful scheme for improving the NAND endurance. I'll conclude my talk. We have presented the DPS approach which actively exploits the device peaks on the NAND endurance and erase voltage and time. And we implemented the DPS aware FTL, which dynamically changes multiple erase voltage and time mode and write mode. By using AutoFTL, we can improve the NAND endurance by 69% on average with a minimal decrease in the write throughput. Thanks for listening to my talk. Thank you.
Jeff Canning, Harvey Mudd College. I have a question about the physics. I don't know if you can answer it, but early on you showed how a high erase voltage causes more electrons to get trapped in the oxide layer. And that's just exactly opposite of what my instincts say should happen. My instincts say, well, if you have a high voltage, the electrons should just go zipping through the oxide layer. So do you have an explanation for why the high voltage makes more things get trapped?
I'm sorry. Could you summarize this one?
So why does the high voltage make more electrons get trapped in the oxide?
That is from the NAND device peaks model. NAND is consist of control gate, floating gate, and tunnel oxide. So the tunnel oxide is the main. Tunnel oxide degradation is main contribution, mainly contribute the NAND endurance degradation. According to the previous device physics, the tunnel oxide reliability of tunnel oxide is proportional to the exponentially proportional to the applied stress voltage and stress time. So and that principle also may be applicable to NAND flash memory.
Okay, thank you.
Itzhak Berg from the Technion. When you say that you need to use finer programming because the VT range you have left is smaller with a lazy erasure, there's one thing I think you're not taking
into. I'm sorry.
You said that when you're using the lazy erasure,
yeah,
where the erased level is wider,
yeah,
you have to write more accurately with,
yeah,
finer steps. But the problem is that part of the reason that the VTs, the threshold voltage, is not accurate is because of effect of neighboring cells, of charge in neighboring cells. And this you cannot compensate for because this happens after you wrote your own cell. So you write your own cell in fine steps, you bring it, let's say, exactly to where you want. But if I program later a neighboring cell, it pulls on it. So part of the reason that these things are wide is not because of the programming that is in coarse steps, it is because of effects of other cells, and this will become more and more pronounced when the technology shrinks. So I think the technique is interesting, but you have to be careful because you cannot compensate for this kind of effect with the finer steps.
I'm sorry, I cannot understand. Could you summarize your question more briefly?
I mean, you showed threshold voltage distributions.
Yeah.
And you showed that when you go to lazy erase, you need to make them narrower.
Right.
And therefore, you program in small steps.
But lazy erase is not a program scheme, but with additional.
It's erasure scheme.
Yeah,
when
right.
you use lazy erase,
yeah,
the erase stays wide.
Yeah.
So you have less room for the others. You need to make them narrow.
Yeah.
So you program, you write in small steps.
Yeah, right.
But the reason they're wide to begin with is to a great extent because of the effect of other cells. It has nothing to do with how finely you program your own. So it will work, but I think less than it appears. We can talk later.
Peter Desnoyers, Northeastern University.
Yeah.
I was curious about the complexity introduced for reading in
yeah.
that you now require a separate read, you need different read thresholds depending on how a page was programmed. And
mm-hmm.
how do you manage that in auto FTL?
Because our auto FTL changes the position of switch voltage dynamically, so the lookup table should be track the which reference read voltage can be most suitable for that write mode. So in this figure, then the setting table and pub rank mode table also keep track of the read reference for each write mode.
Okay, thank you. That does mean, however, that you can't, for instance, scan pages to examine the spare area, for instance, because you can't read a page until you know what voltage level it has.
I think the
we can talk afterwards.
Yeah, okay.